But you know what? Even if we didn't put on a statement, you still would have to go back there and say, I'm not considering that. Why? Why do we take away that common sense presumption of finding out all the information that we can about a case? Because we've already talked about it. If you want to take away somebody's liberty, they got to prove the case. The burden is on the state. And it goes back a long, long way. I've got a quote to talk to you about, a couple of them actually. John Adams, 1770, when we sort of started this experiment a couple hundred years ago. God, I guess it's 250 now. It is more important that innocence be protected than that the guilty be punished. Now, if I stop there, it sort of sounds like I'm asking to let my guilty client go. I'm not. He's not guilty of anything but protecting his own life. But the quote continues, for guilt and crimes that are so frequent in this world that they cannot all be punished. But if innocence itself is brought to the bar and condemned, perhaps to die, then the citizens say, whether I do good or whether I do evil is immaterial. For innocence itself is no protection. And if such an idea as that were to take hold in the mind of the citizens, then it would be the end of security whatsoever. I have a quote of my office that talks about that in a different way from the 1700s in Nina, where my family came from in Ireland. I was there to visit, but never was there. But it also talked about, this is not a death penalty case, obviously that was a death penalty case where they were talking about a guy going to the gallows. And the question was condemning somebody and not being absolutely certain as to your decision. And sending him to the gallows, not because he was guilty, but because maybe he was innocent. And maybe he just didn't know. So that's why we have a system that puts so much of a burden properly on the state attorney's office in this case, to make sure that we don't cut any corners and we don't make any assumptions. And this is a compliment to you because Thomas Jefferson talked about you guys about 200 years ago as well when he said, I consider trial by jury as the only anchor ever yet imagined by man by which government can be held to the principles of its constitution. That's you guys. I think he was talking about jurors in general, but it applies to you as well, because we talked about living the Constitution. Well, planned or not, you guys are it. You are living the Constitution. And we'll go over a little bit of it, but I talked to you about it already. This is a solemn matter. We don't take this lightly, whether it's through jokes or kidding around, or you see us smiling at each other or whatever. This is a serious, serious matter for Mr. Zimmerman.